Today we're going to continue with place value and learn about a skill 10 times the number. Take a look at the first example, 14,588. You notice that the 5 is underlined. Now here's a question. How many times greater is the hundreds digit than the 5 in the tens digit? Let's see. Well, what is the value of the 5 in the hundreds digit? The 5 in the hundreds place is 500, correct? Now, what is the value of the 5 in the tens place? It is 50. 50 times 10. You can do this mentally, right? Anything times 10 just adds a 0 to the end. 1 times 5 is 5, and we have 2 zeros, 1, 2. So, 50 times 10 is 500. So if I ask the question, how many times greater is the 5 in the hundreds place than the 5 in the tens place? You would say times 10. Let's take a look at this next example. 367,794. Now, what if I said, can you circle the digit that is 10 times the 7 in the hundreds place? Let's look at this. 7 in the hundreds place, the value would be 700, right? Now, what is 10 times 700? Times 10 would be 7,000. Just add one extra zero. All right, now look at this 7. The value of this 7 just so happens to be 7,000 because it is in the thousands place. So if I said, can you circle the digit that is 10 times the 7 in the hundreds place? You would circle this digit right here. Now, are you noticing something? The 5s are the same, the 7s are the same. As long as the digits are the same, right next to each other, the value is 10 times the other. Now, let's try another example. All right, so here's another type problem that is still with the same skill of times 10. Let's look at this question. When 436 is multiplied by 10, which is true about the digit 3 in the product? Now, that's kind of wordy, isn't it? It's a lot of words. You know the word product just means answer. And we know that 436, when it is multiplied by 10, we know how to do that as well. So let's go ahead and solve 436 times 10. Now you know it's just 1 times 436 and just add a 0 to the end. Now that's the easy part. So basically you're almost finished with this problem. But be careful. When it says when 436 is multiplied by 10, which is true about the digit 3 in the product? Now here is your product. That is your answer. We're looking at the digit 3. Is the value 3? Is the value 30, 300, or 3,000? Well, let's look. Ones, tens, hundreds, thousands. This is the hundreds place. So the value is 300. Your answer is C. You got it? All right. Let's try another one. Okay, so what if we take the same number, but we change the question just a little bit? When 436 is multiplied by 10, which is true about the 4 in the product? Okay, take the same problem, multiply times 10. You get 4,360. Now, what is the value of the 4 in the product? Let's look. Here's the 4. Ones, tens, hundreds, thousands. Is it worth 40, 400, 4,000, or 40,000? It's the thousands place, isn't it? So 4,000 is correct. All right, you're ready for the hardest of the problems that we've done so far with 10 times the number. Let's look at this problem. The value of the digit 3 in 37,854 is 10 times the value of the 3 in what number? Here are your answer choices. Now, you've got to figure out, well, what does this even mean? So, we are going to look at this problem and see if we can write out an equation that would help us solve this right here. What does this even mean? The value of the digit 3 in this number. Well, let's look. What is the value of the digit 3? Ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, ten thousands. The value is 30,000. Now, your next clue word is this right here. Is. Is another symbol that we know that means equals in the math language. So far, this is what we have for our equation. 3 equals, or 30,000 equals. Now, here's the next part. We can fill this in. 10 times the value of the 3 in what number? Well, I wonder what's going to go in this blank. The 3 in what number is whatever this value is right here. 10 times what equals 30,000. Now, can you think about what we would multiply times 10 to get to 30,000? Let's think about it. It would be a digit with one less zero, would it not? Let's look. Let's see if we take one of the zeros away. 3,000 times 10, does that equal 30,000? 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes, it would. Because anytime you multiply times 10, it adds a zero to your product. So, now, can this information help us find an answer over here? I think it can. So, we're looking for a 3 that is in the thousands place. This is a 3 in the 10,000s place. Oh, here's a 3 in the thousands place. Here's a 3 in the 100,000s place. And here's a 3 in the hundreds place. Now, let's look back at the problem. The value of the digit 3 in 37,854 is 10 times the value of the 3 in what number? Look at that. Do you see a 3 in the thousands place? So B is our correct answer because your 3 is in the thousands place. 3,000 times 10 is 30,000. All right, that's kind of hard, isn't it? With practice, you'll get it. Thanks for watching.